Hello, Patrick Walchuk here with the Agent in Ottawa team, and we're going to do a video right now about the City of Ottawa's new garbage bag limit collections, and it's going to start this fall. We're filming this on June 4th, 2024, and what I'm going to do is read you a lot of what this new policy entails. So, Ottawa residents will be limited to 3 containers of garbage every 2 weeks starting this fall as the City looks to reduce the amount of waste heading to the Trail Road Landfill. A report from the Environment and Climate Change Committee says the new 3-bag garbage item limit will be in effect as of Monday, September 30th, with a 3-month phased-in approach to the new cap on garbage items collected by staff. Now, under the new plan, collection staff will collect all the garbage items left at the curb in October, even if the 3-bag garbage limit is exceeded. Staff says crews will record and leave a custom non-compliance tag indicating that the limit and how to indicating the limit and how to properly participate in waste diversion programs. Then in November, the following month, at households exceeding the 3-bag garbage limit, staff will record and leave 1 item behind with a custom non-compliance tag. And then rounding it out in December, at households exceeding the 3-garbage bag limit, households exceeding the 3-bag limit, only 3 garbage bags will be collected with a non-compliance tag affixed to it. Now, households that set out more than 3 items of garbage a week could be able to set out additional garbage bags in a yellow bag. So the city is going to sell these bags in 4 packs for $17.60 plus HST, so basically $5 a garbage bag. And they will be available at all client service offices, 10 home hardwares throughout the city, and 1 BMR store. Now, that's what the city's been reporting. Here's my thoughts or comments about part of this as it relates to investment properties or small landlords. So I don't know how the city plans to deal with small landlords. So I'd encourage you to contact your counselor to determine how this is going to be done. Specifically, I'm thinking about investors who own bungalows with secondary dwelling units, SDUs, or those with a duplex or even a triplex in which it's not easy to discern if it's a single family home or a 3 unit. And there's a lot of times you can walk down a street and you see a house and you really can't tell if that's a single family house or it's a 3 unit. You might only be able to tell, you know, if there's 3 mailboxes out front or on the side of the house, there's 3 or 4 hydrometers. Otherwise, it looks like a single family house. Now, if tenants put out 9 bags and the garbage man only picks up 3, one has to consider how to immediately deal with it, or you're going to be looking at rodent infestation and angry tenants. Now, after I wrote that, there was an update provided in the Ottawa Citizen just a couple of days ago. And they had facts, frequently asked questions, and one of them was, does my basement renter also get 3 items? And the answer is no. So homes with basement apartments or coach houses will not have a higher item limit, with staff explaining in their report that owners pay just 1 curbside garbage rate for the entire property. That sure doesn't seem fair to me. So if you're a small landlord and you've got 2 apartments with the basically ability of tenants to put out a total of 6 bags, the city's got to find a way to fix that. I don't know how they do it. I'd contact your counselor. Maybe one way is that you, the landlord, are given a different color bag, maybe, I don't know, a blue bag for the secondary dwelling unit, and so they would have 3 blue bags they can put out, which would signify to the garbage collector that this is actually an apartment building. I don't know what the fix is. I'm just saying it seems patently unfair and that you should contact your counselor. If you have any other questions about this, don't hesitate to call me. Thank you.